Today, I stand before you to tell you the story of a boy who dared to dream. The product of a small village love story, molded from birth by the realities of growing up in an impoverished village. Stamped a fatherless black boy as an infant and handed the weight of social challenges that come with the label. Drawn by the mirage of the land of opportunity and filtered through the broken US immigration system. Taught to never wear a hoodie and keep his hands where they can be seen at all times, lest the wrong move leave him laying on a sidewalk. Forced to sit on the hard, cold mahogany benches of the US court system. And there, he watches his mother plead not to be deported back to a country that watched the murderers of her husband walk free. He's told to celebrate as his mother is sentenced to 3 months in prison because at least it's not deportation. Teachers tell him to work hard so he can pull himself up by the bootstraps. His city celebrates. He's a local exemplar for earning a scholarship to the Ivy League. It's a place where faces like his are scarce. He's forced to work twice as hard to bridge the gap of public school education in a world where wealth buys opportunity. And today, he's allowed to wield an engineering degree from an Ivy League institution and can be grateful because things like this don't happen to people like him. At this point in the story, I'll tell you that this little boy is me, but not so that we can delight in a black success story or hold on to the hope that a rose can grow out of concrete, but rather to urge us to dream. To dream of a world where black success is not an anomaly. Where the story of black success is not overcoming excruciating odds at every turn. I urge us to dream of a world where immigrant mothers do not have to give up their dreams to support their children or give up their children. Where black death is not reduced to an Instagram story repost. Where deportation is not a weapon that our government uses to threaten black and brown people. A world where your household income does not determine the quality of education that you can receive. I'm dreaming of challenging the very systems that allow us to see black success as exceptional and not normal. We can dream together of a brown university where African-American faces are not an oddity. Where we can walk into a classroom and not be victimized by imposter syndrome. We can dream together of a school system in which you cannot count the number of black and brown professors that you've had on one hand. Dream of equity. Dream of change and dream of a more inclusive future. There's a power in dreaming because it cannot be taken from us. This world can strip us of our rights, our humanity, our autonomy, but even it cannot take away our ability to dream. So let dreaming be our intimate act of resistance. Dare to dream before you've seen the mountain move, before the skies have cleared, before you have a clear plan. No matter how many times they tell you that it cannot be done, dream, immigrant child. Dream, black girl. Dream, black boy. Dream, all of you who are wondering when things will change. Dream, all of you who are fighting generational trauma. Dream, you who lost your father. Dream, you aspiring politician. Dream, future doctor. Dream, writer. Dream, artist. Dream, class of 2021. Our dreams will usher change into this world because our lives depend on them. Eleanor Roosevelt once said that the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. So today, class of 2021, I ask you, what are your dreams? What keeps you awake at night? What areas must we all see change in before we bring another generation into this world? What areas of our neighborhoods can we not walk by without feeling both angered and galvanized? As we enter into a world that is full of brokenness and inequality, I urge us to hold on to these dreams, to let them guide us when we are lost and without direction. When the mountain of hopelessness seems too large to overcome. When questions like, what's the point, begin to plague our minds. And when the wheel of change seems far too slow for us. For those moments, I remind us of the little girl who dreams to be in the seats that we are all in today. But this country has already told her no on the basis of her skin. Or the children who don't have the luxury of dreaming because they've been given cage floors instead of beds. When we feel hopeless, I say again, dare to dream, class of 2021. We will be the ones who will dream of the better world that will come to be. The ones that will take those dreams and work to see them come to fruition. So I'll leave you with the question, 2021. What will this world look like? Because you have chosen to dream.